Good morning students. In this video we will discuss some problems on circles. Objective: already I made a video which was circles 1. Now this is circles 2. Let us see some more problems. So read the question properly and understand the question. If the lines, two lines are given, if the two lines are tangents to a circle, then what is the radius of the circle? These are the options. So two lines are given that they are tangents to a circle. These two lines, you please see the lines, these are the two lines, they are tangents to a circle. What is this? By watching the equations of these two lines, they are parallel lines. If you take 2 common here, this is also 3x minus 4y. Slopes are equal. What is its slope? 3 by 4. What is its slope? 6 by 8. Nothing but 3 by 4. Therefore, I shall take figure. This is the given circle, you suppose. These two lines are tangents. They are clearly parallel lines, no? Therefore, they will be like this. They are parallel lines. So what will be this? This will be diameter of the circle. What is this? Double the radius. This is center. This is R. This is R. The distance between the lines will be diameter. So since these are two parallel lines, what is the first line? 3x minus 4y plus 4 is equal to 0. And what about second line? 6x minus 8y minus 7 equal to 0. So we will calculate distance between these two lines, that will be diameter. Once you get diameter, half of diameter only radius. So now we shall calculate distance between these two parallel lines. In straight lines, we have seen a formula. Distance between two parallel lines, mod C1 minus C2 by root over A square plus B square. That formula is applicable when this part is same. Even though they are parallel lines, now this XY part is different, no? To apply that distance between two lines, this part should be same. So here you take 2 common or you multiply with 2. So I will multiply first equation by 2. Then this will be 6x minus 8y plus 8 equal to 0. Now taking these two equations, I will find the distance between parallel lines. What is distance between parallel lines? That will be diameter, no? So diameter of the circle is distance between two lines, mod C1 minus C2 by root over A square plus B square. We will substitute the values. Mod of C1 means constant in the first line, C2. C1 minus C2. C2 is minus 7, therefore minus into minus plus 7. By root over A square, you can take any one. A is 6 in both, therefore A square is 36. B square is minus 8 whole square, 64. 8 plus 7 is 15. And what is this? 100. Root 100 is 10. That means it is 3 by 2. What is this? Diameter 2r. Asked radius, no? Therefore radius will be half of this. That means 3 by 4. Therefore answer is second option. Second question. Tangents AB and AC are drawn to this circle from a point capital A, 0, 1. Then the equation of the circle passing through ABC points is, let us see. Yes, here a circle is given. This is the given circle. This is the given circle. From a point means point is external point. From this point capital A, 0, 1, tangents AB and AC are drawn to the circle. AB, this is meeting the circle in B and this is in C. AB and AC are tangents drawn to the circle from a point 0, 1. What he asked then, the equation of circle passing through ABC. He asked this circle. This is the required circle. In concepts of circle, we have seen a concept. These are two tangents, and what is this line? This line is chord of contact. Circumcircle of triangle ABC passes through center of the given circle. And moreover, this line will be a diameter for the new circle. This line will be a diameter. You please refer the concept video. So this circumcircle of ABC, that is circle passing through ABC, will definitely passes through center of the circle. From the equation of the circle, what is the center? 1, -2. This is center. Therefore, this circle passing through ABC, for this line is a diameter. Already I said that. If you join these two, for the given circle, this line is tangent and this line is normal. This is what? 90 degrees. Definitely, this chord is a diameter of this. So now we have extremities of diameter. Therefore, we can write the equation of the circle. What is its equation when extremities are given? X minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. Or this can be multiplied. It can be written in another form. This you should remember directly. X square plus y square minus x into sum of x coordinates minus y into sum of y coordinates plus x1 x2 plus y1 y2. How we obtained this? By multiplying, by expanding this only, we got this. You should remember this directly. Very often we will be getting this. So these are the extremities for the circle passing through ABC. Therefore, substituting x square plus y square minus x into sum of x coordinates, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 into x is x. Next, minus y into sum of y coordinates, 1 plus into minus minus 2, 1 minus 2 is minus 1. This is minus 1, minus y in 1 into this is plus. And what about this? X1, X2 is 0, Y1, Y2 is minus 2. Therefore, it is minus 2 equal to 0. This is the equation of the circle. Which option? Second option. Yes. Question number 3. The number of integral values of lambda. The number of integral values of lambda, so that this line, it is a line, first degree equation, so that this line intersects the circle in two distinct points. We have seen in concepts, you must thorough with all concepts, position of a line and a circle. When a line and a circle are given, there arises three chances like this. If line touches the circle, then the condition is D equal to R. When the line cuts the circle in two points, then the condition is D less than R. When the line does not meet the circle, then the condition is D greater than R. In these conditions, R is radius of the circle and D is perpendicular distance from center of the circle to the given line. See, in this case, this is center. What is D? This distance is D. R is what? This is R. R is more. So already I have given those in the conceptual videos. So here the line is touching the line is cutting the circle in two distinct points. Therefore, this condition satisfies. In the condition D is perpendicular distance from center of the circle to the line, or is radius. So we need to write center and radius. I am writing center of the circle. What is center of the circle? Equation is there, no? Center is 3 comma 0. Also we need radius. Therefore radius of the circle r is equal to, radius is what? G square. G square, g is minus 3, square is 9, f square, there is no y term, minus c is 1. What is it? It is root 8. So the given line is that. So the line is cutting the circle in two points, therefore it satisfies the condition d less than r. What is the perpendicular distance from center of the circle to the line? So perpendicular distance, again straight lines, mod ax1 by1 plus c by root over a square plus b square. We shall substitute the point in that. Mod ax1 is what? 3. By1, 0 into something 0, plus c divided by root over a square plus b square. The line is ax plus by plus c. A square is 1 and b square is 4. Less than r. What is r? This is r. So therefore we obtained mod 3 plus lambda is less than. What about this? By cross multiplication, this is root 5. Root 5 into this, root 40. Okay, if I remove mod, I should take plus or minus here. What will be there? 3 plus lambda. Then lambda less than, if I write 3 here, it becomes minus. So lambda less than plus or minus root 40 minus 3. So what he asked here? He asked integral values. Integral values of lambda. Here lambda lies between these two numbers, minus root 40 minus 3. You can write like this. So this implies minus root 40 minus 3 less than lambda less than root 40 minus 3. These are the boundaries of lambda. So between this and this, lambda is lying, but there are some irrational numbers. He asked only integral. Integers means 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. Let us see. What is this? Root 40. 36 is exactly 6. Square root of 36. 40 means more than 36, no? Approximately, I will take some 6.2. So what is this? 6.2 minus 3. Approximate value only. This is what? 6.2 minus 3. So minus 6.2 minus 3 is minus 9.2 less than lambda. What is this? 6.2 minus 3 is 3.3. Therefore, lambda is lying here in this interval. I have taken real line. What is the real line? Minus infinity to plus infinity. So there will be numbers, no? 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. On the left side, we will be having minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. This is minus 9, this is minus 10. Where lambda is lying? Minus 9.2 means approximately here. 3.3, more than 3 here. So lambda is lying in this interval. So how many integral values of lambda are possible? See, Nana. Here 0 and 3 numbers, 4. Minus 1 to minus 9, they are 9 in number. 0, if you add 0, 10. 10 plus 3, 13. Therefore, the integral values of lambda, 13. Next, question number 4. We will read the question. Locus of point of intersection of perpendicular tangents of this circle. Once again, locus of point of intersection of perpendicular tangents of this circle. So let us see. The locus problems, they come in every chapter: straight lines, pair of lines, circle, parabola, ellipse, hyperbola. They are all important. So here is a circle is there, no? This is a given, this is given circle. So what is the problem? Locus of point of intersection of perpendicular tangents. How to proceed locus problems, how to get a locus. There is a working rule we know very well: taking a point, taking condition, writing values. So I am taking a point x1, y1 or directly xy. You can take x1, y1 or directly xy. If you take x1, y1, finally you have to replace x1, y1 by xy. Instead of that, this is objective, no procedure is required. Directly if you take xy, no replacement will be there. So locus of point of intersection of perpendicular tangents. These are two tangents drawn to this. How the tangents are given? That they are perpendicular. That means angle between the tangents is 90 degrees. So from an external point we can draw two tangents. Angle between the tangents is theta, then we have a formula. So you must thorough with all formulas. Tan theta by 2 is equal to r divided by root s11. We will substitute in this. What is theta? Theta is 90 by 245. Tan 45 1, squaring and cross multiplication, this becomes s11 is equal to r square. What is s11? Watching the circle you write s11. S11 notations very important. x1 square, we have taken x only, no? Therefore this is only x1 square, y1 square minus a square, this is s11. R square, what is radius? This is a circle with center 0 0 and radius small a. This is r square, no? Radius is a. So what is there? R square only there, therefore a square. So s11 equal to r square. By simplifying this, this will be x square plus y square equal to 2a square. This is the locus of point of intersection of perpendicular tangents, therefore first option. So what is this question? Locus of point of intersection of perpendicular tangents. Here we have used a concept: because they are perpendicular, angle between them 90, we took angle formula, written 90 in that. This can be done through figure also. See another procedure. So this is the given circle. What is the given circle? Its center is origin 0 comma 0. Radius is small a. We need locus of point of intersection of perpendicular tangents. Now I shall try to take exact figure. I have taken a tangent like this. Its perpendicular tangent will be like this. These are clearly perpendicular tangents. We need locus of point of intersection of perpendicular tangents. So to find the locus of this point, I have supposed it xy. You can also take x1, y1, no problem. Right, this is the given data. This is a given circle. Locus of point of intersection of perpendicular tangents. This point I have taken as xy. Now I will join these two. What will be this? This will be radius of the circle small a. What about this? This is also radius of the circle. This is also a. I will join these two. In locus problem, for a single locus problem, there may be many conditions. You can use any condition, but that should be true. So nothing wrong is here. Everything is okay. Everything is proper. These are perpendicular tangents. I have done this. So for the circle, this line is tangent, this line is, any line passing through center is normal. They are perpendicular. So what is this? It is a right angle triangle now. Since it is a right angle triangle, I can use the Pythagoras theorem as condition. hypotenuse, side opposite to right angle. This is hypotenuse, no? Hypotenuse, what is its length? Its length is distance between these two, x minus 0 whole square, y minus 0 whole square. Now I will use Pythagoras theorem as condition. Hypotenuse square, what is it? X square plus y square equal to side square, a square plus a square is what? 2a square. So this is the locus. Next question, question number 5. Read the question. Locus of the point of intersection of perpendicular tangents drawn one to each of these two circles. Once again, locus of point of intersection of perpendicular tangents drawn one to each of these two circles. These are the given circles. You please see their equations. Both are concentric circles set with center 0, 0 and different radii. I shall take the figure. So I am taking first circle. This is first circle. X square plus y square equal to 8. We know that it represents a circle with center 0, 0. What is 8? 8 is r square. That means radius is root 8. So radius of this circle is root 8. Next we have another circle with same center, concentric with this, with different radii. That radius is more than this, therefore it will be like this. So for this circle, what is its radius? Its radius is root 12. Now let us come to the question. Locus of point of intersection of perpendicular tangents drawn one each of the two circles. I shall take the figure, exact figure I will take. This is tangent of smaller circle, and also I will take a tangent of this bigger circle such that these are perpendicular. So these are perpendicular. We need the locus of this point. Let it be x comma y. So I will try to obtain a condition. I will join these two. This is what? Radius of smaller circle, root 8. And what about this? This one. This is radius of bigger circle, root 12. This is also same. Therefore, it is root 12. And I will join these two. Why? I know this point and this point. When we know these two points, this length can be found. What is its length? X minus 0 whole square, x square, y square. Since it is a locus problem, you can take any condition which is true. Clearly here, this line is tangent, this line is normal, 90 degrees. Again, I can use Pythagoras theorem. Hypotenuse square. What is hypotenuse square? X square plus y square equal to side square plus side square. Side square plus side square is what? Root 8 square is 8 and this is 12. Therefore 8 plus 12 is 20. That's all. This is the answer. Therefore which option? Third option. Yes. Next to question number 6. The normal of this circle. It is a circle. The normal of the circle which bisects the chord cut off by this line. So here a circle is given and a line is given. This line is, he said, it is a chord. That means the line is cutting the circle in two points. If I take the figure, this is the given circle. What is the circle's equation? This is circle's equation. It is not given in the general form. It is in which form? Center radius form. X minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square equal to r square. Therefore, from the equation of the circle, what is its center? Center is h comma k, 2 comma 1. And of course, radius is 4. This is r square. Okay, and a line is given. Given that this line is a chord, that means it is cutting the circle in two points. This is the line whose equation is x minus 2y plus 3 equal to 0, making a chord. Once again, what is the question? He asked normal, the normal of this circle which bisects this. Bisects this means which is passing through midpoint of this. We know normal always passes through center, so it will be like this. And this normal is perpendicular to this. So he asked this normal, it is a normal. Once again, the normal of this circle which bisects. Bisects means passes through midpoint. In circle we have a property, perpendicular bisector of any chord passes through center. Any chord passes through center will perpendicularly bisect this. So we need equation of this normal. Normal is also a line which is perpendicular to this. Therefore, equation of the normal can be taken as, normal is a line perpendicular to this. Any line perpendicular to this is 2x plus y plus k equal to 0. Normal passes through this point. Yes, it is passing through 2 comma 1. It has to satisfy, substitute in this. 4 plus 1 plus k equal to 0 implies k is equal to minus 5. That's all. Therefore, what is the normal's equation? 2x plus y plus k, where k is minus 5 equal to 0. Therefore, third option. Next question, question number 7. Read the question. If the line y equal to x touches the circle at capital P, where OP is given, OP length is given 6 root 2, then what is C value? Very simple. This is a circle. Given in general form, no problem. I shall take figure. This is the given circle. And a line is given. This line, which line? Y equal to x. We know that it is a line passing through origin. This line is touching the circle like this. This line is touching the circle at the point capital P. What is the line? Y equal to x is the line. This line is touching the circles at the point capital P such that OP equal to 6 root 2. What is O? O is origin. So where is origin? This circle, it contains C, therefore it will not pass through origin. But what is the line Y equal to X? Y equal to X is a line passing through origin. Therefore, definitely origin will lie on this. Origin means 0, 0. This length, OP length is given 6 root 2. What is OP length? OP length means it is length of the tangent. Length of the tangent from origin to this circle. So in concepts we have seen, what is length of the tangent? Length of the tangent is root S11. This is OP distance. What is OP? OP is, this line is a tangent. OP means length of the tangent from origin to this line. This is given 6 root 2. Squaring both sides, S11 is equal to 36 into 2, 72. S11, watching the circle, you write S11. X1 square, Y1 square, plus 2GX1. Plus 2FY1 plus C, this is 72. But in the problem, what is the point X1, Y1? Tangent is drawn from 0, 0. Length of the tangent from 0, 0. X1 is 0, Y1 is 0. If you substitute, these are all become 0. We will have only C. Therefore, C value is 72. Therefore, third option. Question number 8. If capital O origin 0, 0, capital A 1, 0, capital B 1 by 2, root 3 by 2, 3 points are given. Then the center of the circle for which the three lines OA, OB and AB are tangents. This is the question. So see here, 3 points are given now. This is O. This is point A and one more point is given B. With these three points, we obtained three lines OA, OB and AB. What is to be find the center of the circle for which these three lines are tangents? That means we need the center of the circle touching these three lines, of course, internally. This center is required. Once again, see the question. Three points are given, then the center of the circle for which the three lines are tangents. For this circle, these three lines are tangents. We need center of this circle. For the triangle, what is this circle? It is in circle. What is this? This is in circle. Circle touching three lines internally is called in circle. So center of this circle is what? In center. What is it? In center. In first year we have seen coordinate system, straight lines. What is in center? Point of intersection of internal angle bisectors. For that there is a formula AX1 plus BX2 plus CX3 by A plus B plus C. AY1 plus BY2 plus CY3 by A plus B plus C. In that formula, X1, Y1, X2, Y2, X3, Y3, they are vertices. What about small a, small b, small c? They are lengths of the sides. So here we need lengths of the sides. Therefore, let us find those three first. Already we have vertices. OA distance means distance between O and A. 1 minus 0, 1 whole square is 1. 0 minus 0, 0. What is it? It is 1. Next distance, OB distance. Distance between O and B. 1 by 2 minus 0, 1 by 2 square is 1 by 4. Root 3 by 2 minus 0, root 3 by 2 only. If I square this, this will be 3 by 4. What is this? 1 by 4, 3 by 4, 1 only. Next distance, next side is AB side. What is the length of AB side? Take this and this. 1 minus 1 by 2, 1 by 2, square is 1 by 4. 0 minus root 3 by 2 minus root 3 by 2 square is 3 by 4. So therefore this is also 1. These are the lengths of the sides. So all the three lengths, they have come equal. Lengths of the three sides of the triangle are equal. Therefore what is this? The triangle OAB is equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. Actually, in this problem, we need to find the center of this circle for which three lines are tangents. That means in center. Since it is equilateral triangle, we have a concept in equilateral triangle, orthocenter, circumcenter, centroid, in center, they all coincide. Therefore, I can find the center of the circle which is in center, which is nothing but centroid because it is an equilateral triangle. Centroid can be easily find when vertices are given. X1 plus X2 plus X3 by 3. What is this? 0 plus 1 plus 1 by 2 by 3. Comma Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 by 3. 0 plus 0 plus root 3 by 2 by 3. Simplify this. This will be what? 1 plus 1 by 2 is 3 by 2. If I cut 3, 3, this will be 1 by 2. This is what? Root 3 by 2 root 3. 3 root 3 root 3 times. Therefore, 1 by 2 root 3. Therefore, answer is center of the circle is 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2 root 3. Therefore, what is it? It is second option. Yes. Next question. Question number 8. The nearest point on this circle from the given point. Very simple. Here a circle is given. I shall take figure. This is the circle. We know its center. Center can be written. What is its center? Capital C. 3 comma minus 2. You calculate its radius. What is its radius? Root over. G square minus 3 whole square, F square is 4, minus C, minus into minus plus 12. What is it? Root 25 means 5. So we have seen a concept. nearest, shortest distance, longest distance. This depends on same concept. Here a point is given, no? Say this is the given point, which is capital P, minus 5 comma 4. What is the question? The nearest point on the circle. On the circle, there will be many points. Among those points, we have to find the point nearest to this. That means you should draw a line passing through center like this. This line meets the circle here and here. Okay, now you can draw many lines. You will have many points on this. This is only the nearest point to capital P. Point on the circle nearest to capital P is A. Now we have to find this point capital A. So how to find capital A? I will find the distance CP here. In the concept we have denoted it by D. Because this point is given, we know center. You please calculate this. What is radius of the circle? Radius is 5. Okay, we will see the distance. 3 minus into minus plus 5. 8 whole square is 64. Minus 2 minus 4 minus 6 whole square is this. D is 10. What is D? Distance from center to the given point. Now see. So radius of the circle is 5. CP distance is 10. This distance is 10. Already this is 5. No, this is also 5. This is of course 5. So we have to find the point A in the question, in this problem. So we know which points. We know P point and C point. In this problem, this is 5, this is 5. Therefore, what is A? The nearest point A is midpoint of CP. Clearly, 5 units, 5 units. This is what? Midpoint. Midpoint can be calculated easily, no? X1 plus X2 by 2 minus 5 plus 3 by 2. And Y1 plus Y2 by 2 is equal to, what is this? Minus 5 plus 3 minus 2 by 2 is minus 1. 4 minus 2, 2 by 2 is 1. So answer is minus 1 comma 1. Therefore, second option. Here this and this have come equal. In some problems, they may different. For example, if you find this radius is 5, if you get CP equal to some 12, then this is 5, no, then this will be 7. Then how to find this? In this case, A divides the line PC in the ratio 7 is to 5 internally. Depending on the ratio, you should find. Next question, question number 10. A line is at a distance of small c. A line is at a distance of small c from origin and meets the coordinate axis in A comma B. Let us draw this figure first. So these are the axis, x-axis, y-axis. This is origin. What he said, a line is at a distance of C from origin and meets the axis in A comma B. Say this one. I shall take line like this. You suppose this is the line which is at a distance of C from the origin, perpendicular distance from origin to this line. This distance is given small c, perpendicular distance. This line meets the axis in A comma B points. These are AB points. What is the question? Once again, now we will read the question completely. Reading is very, very important. You can do the problem if you understand the problem. Without understanding, you could not do the problem. To understand the problem, you need to read the problem properly. There are some basics. For any subject, first of all, you should read the question properly, thoroughly. Then you should come to understand. Then you will understand the question, what is given, what is to be found. Then you can use your concept. See, no. A line is at a distance of C from origin and meets the axis in A comma B. I have taken. Line is at a distance of C from this, meets the axis in AB. The locus of center of the circle passing through OAB. There are 3 points now, OAB. There is a circle passing through 3 points like this. Asked center of this circle, locus of center of that circle. Listen carefully. So for this circle, clearly here x-axis, y-axis are perpendicular. This angle is 90. What is this? This is angle made by this chord. This is a chord for the circle. If angle made by a chord at a point on the circle is 90, then this chord must be a diameter. Center of the circle means midpoint of diameter. So asked the locus of center of the circle. Center of the circle is midpoint of this one. So to find the locus of this. So in straight lines chapter, we have seen a formula. If a line is cutting axis in A comma B, if midpoint of AB is given, then directly we can write the equation of line AB. What is equation of line AB? X by X1 plus Y by Y1 is equal to 2. This is equation of line AB, where X1, Y1 is midpoint of this. Here, what is the condition? It is a locus problem. What is the condition? Perpendicular distance from origin to the line is given C. So condition, now I am taking condition because it is a locus problem. What is the condition? Perpendicular distance from origin to AB line means this line. Perpendicular distance from origin to a line, formula is there, mod C by under root of A square plus B square. If I use that, mod C divided by root over A square, what is A? Line is AX plus BY plus C. A means X coefficient. Here X coefficient is 1 by X1. A square means 1 by X1 square. B square means 1 by Y1 square. This distance is given C, so equal to C. Root is there, mod is there, squaring and cross multiplication. 1 by X1 square plus 1 by Y1 square. This 2 becomes 4, this becomes C square if I write here this one. So therefore, locus has come, replace X1, Y1 by XY. So you please see options. What he did in the options? So therefore, this can be simplified as 1 by X1 square. In low Y, while writing locus, X1, Y1, they are replaced by XY, no? Therefore, this is 1 by X square, can be written as X power minus 2. And this is Y power minus 2. 4 into C square can be C power minus 2. Therefore, this is the locus. Which option? Third option. Next question number 11. If two tangents are drawn from a point on this circle, a circle is given. If two tangents are drawn from a point on this circle, we know everything about this circle. It is a circle with center 0, 0, radius 4. If two tangents are drawn from a point on that circle to another circle, it is also a circle with center 0, 0. Radius is what? Root 8. That's radius is root 16. It is root 8. That is bigger circle. Then angle between the tangents is very simple. We shall take figure. So there is a circle here whose center is 0, 0, of course. Radius is root 8. What is that? That is also a circle with center 0, 0. Means concentric circle. With different radius, of course, 4. Now, what is the question? If two tangents, so this smaller circle is x square plus y square equal to 8. And this circle is x square plus y square equal to 16. Read the question properly. If two tangents are drawn from a point on the circle, x square plus y square equal to 16, this bigger circle. From a point on this circle, tangents are drawn to smaller circle. What is angle between the tangents? This angle is to be find. To find this angle, we have a formula. To find angle between tangents in circles, tan theta by 2 equal to r divided by root s11. Tangents are drawn to this circle. We need a point, no? So point is not given. I will suppose x1, y1 is a point. This point, it is a point on this circle. If a point lies on a circle, it has to satisfy s11 is 0. If I substitute in this, x1 square plus y1 square equal to 16. So we have taken a point on this circle. What he said, from a point on this circle, tangents are drawn to this. Therefore, I took a point here. Since it is a point on the circle, it satisfies the equation. That's what I have written. This is question number 12, I think. Okay, now from this point, tangents are drawn to this. Which tangents are drawn to this circle? You should consider this. So tan theta by 2 equal to r. What is radius of this circle? It is root 8 divided by root s11. For the circle, root s11 is x1 square y1 square minus 8. But x1 square y1 square is 16 because this is a point on bigger circle. So here you can write that value. x1 square y1 square is what? 16. 16 minus 8. This is also root 8. Root 8, root 8 gets cancelled. It is 1. So tan theta equal to 1. What does it mean? Theta by 2 equal to 45 degrees. So angle is theta, no? Therefore theta equal to pi by 2, 90 degrees. Therefore first option.